So let me give you an insight of what is data science and what is the importance of data science. So data science is basically a complete process of finding business solutions. Okay. So who is a data scientist? A data scientist has been said to be the sexiest job in the next 10 years by the chief economist at Google. And the data age has arrived. From crowdsourced product reviews to real-time traffic alerts, data science has become a regular part of our daily life. So no matter what we are doing, we are using data science in one way or another. Now, what is data science? Data science is the extensive use of data, statistical and quantitative analysis, explanatory and predictive models, and fact-based management to derive decisions and actions. So basically, we will be having a problem at hand, a business problem, and we are trying to find out the solution to that particular business problem. So for finding out the solution, first of all, the main thing is to understand what the problem is. And once we understand the problem, then we use the data which is present in the organization, we analyze the data, we work on that data, we apply machine learning to that data to basically derive an insight from it, or to learn from it, or make predictions, or maybe do some kind of action on that particular data so that we could achieve something. So these are a few definitions of data science. So basically, in data science, we are basically applying the domain knowledge to solve business problems. We are trying to convert raw data into knowledge so that we could support decision making. We are trying to find out different patterns to improve business, society, or personal performance. And basically, we are trying to move towards a better decision making. Why is data science used? Because decision making is now a fact and performance based. Okay, so earlier decision making was done by hunches and experiences, but now people are looking for proper facts and analysis before taking any action and before making any particular decisions. So instead of intuitions, people are looking at metrics. Okay. And because there is an intense competition, so the business executives need to make decisions faster, and they want to have the least amount of risk possible in any decision that they make, right? And then everyone wants to make each and every dollar count, and they want a good return on investment. So that is where data science helps in. And it helps people to take real-time decisions. Now, what does a data scientist do? Data scientist helps in identifying the data analytics problems that offer the greatest opportunities to the organizations. He helps in determining correct data set and variables. They help in collecting large sets of structured and unstructured data from different sources. So again, in this particular course, we will be working on different kind of data sets. We will be working on structured data and also on unstructured data, and we will be using both the data to basically build our models. Then we will be learning how to clean and validate the data, okay, so that we get better accuracy and completeness and uniformity in our results. So that's the same thing what data scientists also do, right? Data scientists also help in devising and applying models and algorithms to mine the stores of big data. So basically, the main target is to mine the data to get all the structured and unstructured data and apply machine learning algorithms so that we could get some insight, find out some particular patterns and solutions to a particular problem, and then to be able to communicate that further to different stakeholders using visualization and other means. Now, if you see here, so these are various industries which are present and using data science already. So if you see, we have banking, credit card, hospitals, investment funds, stock market, manufacturing, sales, healthcare, NGOs, airlines, social networking, education. So everywhere, you just name the domain and everywhere you will find data science and machine learning being used. So what is data science about? So basically, we are trying to find out insight. So there is a complete list of texts which you need to know, like scientific methods, mathematics, statistics, then advanced computing, visualization. You need to have a mindset which is out of the box. You need to have domain expertise. You need to become a data engineer as well. So everything is associated with data science. Okay. So what we will be learning is taking every aspect in consideration. You will begin with data engineering. So you will begin with basically working on data, understanding how data needs to be modified for any project creation, and before putting into model, how we transform data, what all do we do with the data, how we convert the categorical data into numerical data. So all those things we will be learning. Then comes in how we create different models. So we will be learning different algorithms, and we will learn how to apply those algorithms to create our projects. Further, we will learn how to estimate how good our models are, and then we will learn how to use our models for prediction. These are a few examples of machine learning being used in data science. So you can have a look at these. Now, what is machine learning? So we have been talking about data science entirely, but we haven't answered the question that what is machine learning yet. So okay, we are trying to find out business insight and we are trying to solve business problems, but where does machine learning come in? So you have a lot of data and you want to analyze it. That's fine, you can do that. And after that, you want to make certain predictions. You want to find out what future could be, what your sales could be, what is your maybe your sales dependent on, or what could be the outcome of something. So there are a lot of things which you would need to predict, or maybe group together, or maybe do analysis on. So machine learning is basically helping us out to, instead of write long pieces of code and directly writing something which could learn at its own, because we already have a lot of data in hand, why write if-else conditions to understand it when we can directly let the machine learn itself? The main focus here is that if you think of any other programming, right, when you think of your procedural programming, let's say, so what do you do? You basically tell your system to find out, or maybe let's take an example of a self-driven car. So what you can do is, you have a self-driven car, okay? Now you want to explain to it what it should do and what it should not do, right? So one thing is, you can make a list of, say, 1,000 scenarios which could occur, like maybe someone could be crossing the road, maybe someone is sleeping on the road, maybe there is another car coming from the front, or maybe there is a big stone, or maybe there is an earthquake. There could be thousands of such scenarios, and you will tell the machine that what if this condition happens, then do something else, and then so on. But let's say you have covered 1,000 scenarios and still there is one scenario which is left. Let's say that one scenario occurs. So that one particular scenario would be a cause for an accident. So that is something which we want to avoid. So for that, we do not want to learn those 1,000 scenarios and still be left with something which is not known to us. What we do is, we basically tell the machine a simple list of scenarios. Okay, this is the data. So as per the data, these all scenarios can occur. So based on that, the machine would not be trained on an if-else condition. That machine will learn itself that if something like this occurs, if there is something maybe close enough to this, then you need to do something like this. So you don't really give proper instructions, but you let the machine learn itself. So that is what machine learning is. It is basically about providing data to the machine so that it could understand the data and draw conclusion itself. Okay, so machine learning is an application of artificial intelligence that provides systems the ability to automatically learn and improve from experience without being explicitly programmed. Machine learning focuses on the development of computer programs that can access data and use it to learn for themselves. Right? So this is what machine learning is. Now, why do we focus on becoming a data scientist? The main thing is that it needs a lot of out-of-box thinking. It needs a creative mind. Then there are already more than 70% male data scientists, so there is a lot of scope, and there are a lot of on-site opportunities, government jobs, research jobs. So there are a lot of jobs which are available, and there would be more upcoming. And we have seen that data scientists have been improving on the pay scales, so that is another good reason. Now, where all is machine learning used? One example is the heavily hyped self-driving Google car, the essence of machine learning. Then online recommendation offers such as those from Amazon, Netflix. This is a machine learning application for everyday life. Then knowing what customers are saying about you on Twitter. Then fraud detection. So these are all important implementations of machine learning. So we will be learning about two main machine learning types, which is supervised learning and unsupervised learning. But we must know what all types are there. So there are three types. One is supervised learning, another one is unsupervised learning, then we have reinforcement learning. Supervised learning makes machine learn explicitly. While unsupervised learning, in this machine understands the data, identifies the pattern and structures. Okay, so in supervised learning, the data will have a clearly defined output. While in unsupervised learning, there is no well-defined output given. There is no output given inside unsupervised learning. It will just try to understand the features and the patterns from the input data itself. So we don't really know what a particular class, something belongs to which class basically. In supervised learning, there is a direct feedback. And in unsupervised learning, evaluation is qualitative or indirect. Then in supervised learning, the prediction, we basically predict outcomes or future, right? And in unsupervised learning, we are not predicting anything. We are not finding anything specific. We are just trying to find the groups or the clusters between data. And supervised learning is used for classification and regression problems. So these are the two types. The third type, reinforcement learning, is an approach to AI. It is basically based on your reward-based learning, which is one from positive and negative reinforcement. So basically, machine learns how to act in a certain environment, and its main objective is to maximize the reward. Okay, so once it finds out that something is rewarding, then it keeps on doing that, and once it finds out that something is not rewarding or something is negative, then it won't do that again. So how supervised learning works? So basically we will have a labeled data. That labeled data will have some features, like we will have certain pictures of cats and we will know that these are cats. So the machine will learn different features from these images, and when after learning these features, it will be able to predict with any new given input if that input belongs to the cat category or not. So this is classification. So here basically we are able to sort items into different categories, like cat or not cat. Then regression is basically used for identifying real life, real values or continuous values. So basically we will be training the machine. The machine would be learning from input and output data that what features result in what kind of values, what kind of continuous values, and it finds some equation or some kind of rule for it, and based on that it calculates the prediction of future values, like amount, weight, age, anything like that. Next is unsupervised learning. So how this works is we basically will not be given any labels. So now we don't really know what is a cat or what is a dog. We just have certain images, which is a mix of cat and dogs. Okay, so what this would be doing is it will try to learn certain features, and then it will try to segregate into different groups, that this belongs to same group and this belongs to another group. So the types of problems which are included are clustering, which is basically identifying similarities in a particular group, like for example, are there patterns in the data to indicate certain patients will respond better to a particular treatment or not. Then another way is finding anomalies, which is to find something different from the usual data, right? This is anomaly detection. So finally, what you would learn from this particular course is Python programming. Then you will be working on multiple industry level projects. Apart from that, you will get in-depth knowledge of algorithms, and then you will get a hands-on practice of machine learning algorithms.